1 week after police swept gang members off their streets, look how folks tonight are celebrating. Evening, everybody. I'm Jack Atherton.
And good evening to you. I'm Cherie Pillow. Yes, neighbors are so relieved they threw a block party tonight. News 5's Laura Borchers takes us to the new Walnut Hills.
Tonight, the door is locked up, and as you can see, the gang hangout is now completely empty. And because it is, people are celebrating right next door.
It had a big impact when they came and took them off the street.
Michelle Gilliam says she has no connection to the man next door, known best as Frog. But when he moved in, bullets began pelting her business.
The window was broken out, bullet holes right there.
The drive-by shooter may have been aiming at the hangout next door, but bullets took out Michelle's front windows, left holes through her walls, and shattered her mirror.
That day has come and gone.
Tonight on the other side of Michelle's carryout, this block party.
We're not going to have it where a street gang comes in and claims a neighborhood and say it belongs to them. It doesn't belong to them.
Nearly 200 residents celebrated recent arrests. Among those grilling and chatting about the new Walnut Hills, some spotted one of those arrested in the drug and gang roundup on October 28th.
If they want to be a vital and a contributing part of the community, they're welcome as well. If not, we'll get them again.
A lot of businesses have closed because of robberies, crimes, a lot of things, and it's time for a transformation. This is a great neighborhood. It's a great location, and it's just time to make positive changes.
Siobhan Bush has always lived here. Tonight, she, like many, brought her whole family to celebrate the revitalization.
It's about the kids. They should feel safe walking up and down the streets.
I want to have a safe community to live in, and I want everyone to respect one another, and I want everyone to love one another.
I don't have to worry about drive-by shootings, you know. I can stay open a little later now, you know, business started to pick back up.
And the night ended with a call out to all of the residents here to volunteer for Citizens on Patrol to help keep these streets safe. If you're interested, call police. In Walnut Hills, I'm Laura Borchers, News 5.